Penguin Random House Audio presents Stop the Spiral Devotional, 100 Days of Breaking Free from Negative Thoughts. This is the author, Jennie Allen. Introduction. God has great timing. Perhaps you're seeing this in your life. Many of us, we've experienced a bit of a wake-up call recently, whether due to global unrest, political tensions, or personal challenges. We've been forced to stop and look at the state of our minds, or we've been confronted with changes that have happened inside of us over weeks, months, and years, and we don't exactly like what we see. But if you're here, maybe it's because you've sensed that now is the time to do something about all that is swirling in and around you. For so many of us who have been paddling busily on the lake of our lives, the lake has suddenly drained, and we've seen what was at the bottom. And what it was a lot of mess, a lot of turmoil, and mental suffering. And rather than it being new junk, maybe it's been on the bottom of our lakes for quite some time, ignored or shoved out of sight until now. But gazing down at it, many of us are thinking, wow, I think I've been anxious for a long time. But I've been so busy that I didn't notice. Or, wow, I've felt depressed and tired for a long time. And maybe I need to get some help. As we consider the state of our minds, we're realizing something has to change. We need a new normal. Maybe you've been struggling with low levels of anxiety for a long time. Or maybe you've recently experienced a season of difficulty or stress that's caused a big spike in anxiety. The past few years of unrest and uncertainty have definitely revealed hidden anxieties many of us were actually already feeling. Whatever your unique situation, you might be asking, what am I supposed to do with these thoughts? What if I told you that you don't have to spiral in toxic thoughts anymore? What if I told you that God has the power not only to save our souls, but also to change our lives? I've seen him do this for other people, and I've seen him do this in me. A few years ago, I went through a season of attack. It was quiet, it was subtle, and I barely noticed, if I'm being honest. It came every night at 3 a.m. when I was jolted awake and simmering anxieties and doubts began to fill my mind. It beat me up for month upon month. And the bad part was, I didn't even realize it was happening. I thought it was just inevitable, that I had no control over it. But I was at war with the devil in the night, and I never admitted it out loud. For 18 months, I never told anybody what was happening. When I finally did mention it to people, the second I did, it was obvious. This was not who I was. I had been spiraling down, listening to lies, but I didn't see it because I was not guarding my mind. So what happened? During month after month of me waking up in the middle of the night and hearing the devil telling me whatever the heck he wanted to alone in the dark, there was a cost to my faith and to my health and to my relationships. Patterns of toxic thinking became grooved into my mind. Maybe you know what that's like, that suffering and feeling out of control. But I can also tell you, when I realized I could fight back, everything shifted. I believe we are at war, that the enemy of our souls is coming for us in ways that we hardly notice, in the fears and anxieties in our minds. I believe that for you. In some way, the enemy is targeting the peace of your mind. Those lies are real to you and coming at you every day. In our generation, we're facing some unique spirals that pull us down and rob us of peace and joy and of the effectiveness that we could have for the kingdom of God. In this journey of rewiring downward spirals, we'll approach them one by one. We'll also look at research in psychology and neuroscience, because in studies of the brain, you cannot deny the power of God in the ways that He built our minds. When it comes to the science of the brain, it backs up the Bible. It's wild. All the truths the Bible gives us about our minds, that we can take every thought captive, and that we have power over our thoughts. All of these truths are also spelled out in science. It's true, there is hope. We can change our minds. Consider this 100-day devotional your invitation to start noticing spiraling thought patterns every day. To start getting wise to these toxic thought spirals that have taken so much of your life and your peace. Yes, the enemy is targeting you. But I'm here to tell you, God loves you, and He is also fighting for you. Our God says that we have the power to destroy strongholds, that we can be transformed by the renewal of our minds, which direct how we live, how we love, and what we will do with our time on the earth. Breaking the cycle of toxic thoughts is an active process, which is why it's important to take it day by day, not passively thinking about whatever pops into our heads, but actively fighting to believe truth and to fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. As we fixate on Him, the things of this earth grow less powerful. This is how we change, imperfectly, slowly, messily even, but turning to Jesus again and again. Jesus is so real and present and here for us in this process, even as we fall and get back up. What's on the other side of this fight? Now that I've done war with this part of my life, after going through it myself, I've never been more joyful, I've never been more free. I've never been more grateful, and I've never been more peaceful. Of course, I still spiral sometimes. Life on this earth can never be an endless victory lap. The goal, though, is not to be some kind of perfect mental ninja. It's to come closer to the God who adores us, who made our minds, and who made it possible for us to join Him in walking in the freedom He gives. Because God has grace for me and you and wants our freedom, we can want it for ourselves. And because it's not done in my own strength or your own strength, we can breathe and have hope that God will do the freeing as we turn to Him each day. A lot can happen in 100 days. Mental pathways can be rewritten, minds can be freed, spirals can be flipped upside down. Whether you go into this journey on your own with a journal and your Bible, or with friends and partners fighting for each other, take this time to get honest and to think about your thoughts, to go to war against the lies, to expand your understanding and compassion, to connect, to pray, to renew your reliance on a God who sets you free. In this book, you'll find 100 days of devotions to challenge your thinking, to encourage you, and to remind you of God's sufficiency and grace on the road to rewiring negative spirals. Each day's reading includes the following: a short devotional essay, verses for meditating on and soaking your soul in God's word, a rewire the spiral statement to speak over yourself, and a prayer for sparking a daily conversation with the creator of your soul who wants to bring peace to your mind. I believe that the battle for your mind matters more than we can possibly understand, and that God wants you to live more freely than you are right now. So I'm praying huge prayers for you, but I also want to pray small prayers that you'll see a glimmer of hope, that God will set you free, and that you will have your eyes opened, that you will see in a new way the enemy and what he wants for you, and that you will have nothing to do with it, that you will go to war, that you will fight better than you ever have, and that you will know what it is to rewire the spirals in your mind. In Jesus' name. Before we begin, your mental health. You may have lived with a low-grade sadness for as long as you can remember, or maybe for you, it's far worse than that. A daily struggle accompanied even by suicidal thoughts. If mental illness is a struggle that you face, may I please wrap my loving arms around you, look in your eyes, and whisper, this, your anxiety or depression or bipolar disorder or suicidal thoughts, is not your fault. You may be suffering from a true chemical breakdown in your body. I get that. Several members of my family depend on medicine to help regulate their brain chemistry. Please hear me. There is no shame in that choice. Praise God for tools that help.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.